Hi guys, I missed you. Today it's Friday morning still, I think. Yep, it is 11:30 in the morning. And I missed you guys yesterday because I had my big team building day yesterday and it was a long day. And I was really, really tired when I got home because there was a lot of information that I had to process and it was a lot of fun. But I'm glad I'm back with you guys. So here I have my donators list. And I want to show you something which is really pretty because I have my prints. I thought I'd have them back by tomorrow, but they had them ready yesterday. So this one is the one that came out of my printer, my home printer. And then this one is what comes back from the professional printer. Can you see the difference? There's a lot of difference because the definition of only this bit is so beautiful. It's much deeper, the colors, and the contrast is better, and you can see that the paper is much shinier because if you frame this would look beautiful. And I really like the job they did. Even the little border around is better. Wait a minute, let me get it. Let me put those together. See how the borders are much more defined? And this is archival paper. So it's Crystal Archival Paper Supreme by Fuji. And they guarantee that this will stay, the colors will stay like this for, I don't know, I think 100 years. So that is pretty. I'm very, very satisfied with the printing. You know, even things like, let's see, up here, where you see the cells coming through the color, but they didn't really make it all the way. And here, you see that the color is so much better, so vibrant and I don't know, just so much more beautiful. But this is so this is the print. Then I'll show you the other ones. So the top one again is the one that came out of my printer, and then here you see the difference. It's now totally different. You wouldn't even expect it's the same colors. That's how much it pops. It's beautiful. Then I have two that you didn't see. I did a square one. This is a square one. And it's about, I'll tell you how big it is when I find my ruler with the inches on it. I got it. It's 6x6. Yep. So it's a little bit smaller than the 20x20 canvases I do. I'll show you that one. So this is a 20x20 canvas. But then if you were to put this in a frame and you put a mat around it, it would look really beautiful. You could even keep the signature, I guess. Whoops. But on the back, I'm going to be putting the certificate of authenticity. So I'm going to make a picture and put it on the certificate and put it on the back. Then I have, I'll show it up close. That's it. I'm trying to put some light on it so you see it better. Okay, so that's that one. And I have a little bit bigger one. This is that's centimeters. This is about 7.5 by 11. 7 by 11. I think that's a sort of a size that some of you told me about. But this is also a really pretty, pretty print. But if you're more for the green and the the rusty color. This is a pretty one. I'm really satisfied with the colors. They pop, really pop. They're beautiful. So, oops, got stuck in my iPad again with my big head, with my hair up. Which reminds me, I have my curlers on. Oh, that doesn't matter. It shuts off by itself. So, I'm going to do one pour today. And then I'm going to go to the box shop. It's a little ways away, but I'm going to go there to see which is the best solution to send these prints. So I'm absolutely going to try to keep them A4 size, because I know they have some sort of a roll, or I'll show you what I mean. See, usually you can let them send you in one of these tubes. And they have them in all sizes, so I'm hoping they have one small enough that goes through what we call the post, the envelope post. It has a certain size, and if you can match, if it can go through there, then it's cheaper to send. But I've had some more prints done in the past. And I'll show that to you without spilling all my, you see that? Is that beautiful or what? Yeah, these are really big. These are, if you put this in a frame, that would look awesome. There's a blue one. These colors are so intense. It's, I don't know how to say it, but it's, wow, they look so pretty. Then I have this one. This one is very pretty also. But can you imagine what this would look like if you had this framed? This is pretty. So let me know about what you guys think. And if I should make bigger prints. I could do that, but I think I'd buy a different camera though. But if I were to be selling these, and because it's so cheap to send them overseas, you know, worldwide, much more cheaper than sending those canvases, because they are, you know, 17 euros for a 20 by 20, 27 euros for a up to a 45 by 45. But sending these would be so... so much cheaper. And if someone says, you know, I'd really like something of yours, but I can't afford the canvas, this would be a great option. So just let me know and I'll get back to you. Oh, but when you do it, please do it with email. My email is under this video. And a lot of people have chipped in helping me to try to explain it. Because a lot of people don't know that there is information under the video. You click down on the little arrow, or there is, someone told me there's more, like a little button thing that says more information. And you click on that and then you see all kinds of stuff. And I might be looking into, you know, you can upload a video and then at the end you can put some sort of a, I don't know what you call it, sort of an image with all the links. I might be looking into that. That might be a good idea. Putting that in the front of the video and in the back of the video. Gotta look into it. But there's this really keeps me busy all day long, so I don't have much, you know, time to figure things out and practice making stuff better on the video. So we'll just have to do with it, right? Can't have everything. So I've got my colors all mixed up, you already see over here. So one more time, I want to thank everyone that donated. And people, it's not about the amount. Again, a lot of people donated. And then they put underneath the donation, they put, you know, I'm sorry I can't give you more. But I don't want to hear that, because I love you all, really, truly, from the bottom of my heart. It's not about the amount that you're donating. It's about that you care about my channel and about me. and about that I can go make more experiments. So please don't put that under there, because that makes me feel real bad. You know, if you can't afford it, please don't do it. Because, you know, I wouldn't want you know, you giving me money if you can't afford to do that. That makes me really feel yucky. So don't. Thank you all for this. And tomorrow, I've already printed out the names twice. So tomorrow I'm going to be cutting out the little, how do you call it, when I put in the big hat. You got to help me there. Will someone put that under in the comments? How do you call it when you cut out someone's name and fold it, a little ticket, and you put it in a hat? I don't know. Here we call it loodjes, loodjes trekken. So just help me there that I know what you guys call that. But I'm going to be doing that tomorrow. So tomorrow raffle, and I'm going to do, I think, depends on the packaging that I can get. But it's going to be 166, or it's going to be 2 times 166, the stamps that I have to put on the package. So it depends on that. But I think I'll be doing like 4 giveaways tomorrow. Okay? Okay. Then another thing. I want to say, oh, so sorry about the second layer of the big painting. I thought that camera was good, but I didn't even check it. I just uploaded it, and the first person that saw it said, you, it's so dark, I can't see a thing. And I went back to check, and I got a scare. I thought, how can you see anything at all? It's so dark. So I'm not going to be doing that anymore either. I will be using that camera, but only when I'm doing something here, and you have to see, have to have a side view. And then maybe when I do a big pouring, but then I'll do that during the day when I can pull up all the blinds and there's enough light so you can see it. So sorry about that. Won't happen again. And to tell you the truth, I'll show you after this, after the pour. But I'm going to show you the big painting. It's done. I'll get it off my drying rack. Hear me, I have a drying rack. Yeah, right, it's my ironing board. So I'm going to show you in a minute, but I'm not liking the big painting because I don't like the colors. And I thought that while I go to the box shop this afternoon, I'll run by the shop where I bought this big canvas. I'm going to buy another, yep. And for two reasons. One is a lot of people asked me to show them how I did the background. So I can show you that tomorrow in a video. And then I'm going to do exactly the same pour, only I'm going to pour it in once, at once, because I have color difference. And I'll show you that after I do the pour. So let's get us a nice new canvas. That's the canvas. Taking all the stuff out, the little pins. That's it. And then I want to put the push pin in. So we're gonna get the push pins in. Oh, that box isn't open yet. Like that. And the problem is I do have to hammer them in, so close your ears because I'm gonna be hammering. But I can do it pretty quickly because I think I'm a pretty good hammerer. Carpenter. That's it. And I'm putting them in the corners because that's the better place to do it. And now you're wondering, have you ever hit your own thumb? Well, tons of times. But that doesn't matter, as long as you're having fun, right? Okay, we're ready. So we have our little canvas. We have the push pins in place. See how easy that was? I have these. I bought myself a little hammer because my husband has all the tools downstairs, and every time I get something, he's going from, when you're ready, bring it back. You have to put it back in the place you found it. I think, you know, I'll just buy a little hammer. And do you know what they call this? They call it a weekend hammer. And do you know why? Because here, you can open a beer bottle with it. Is that funny or what? Yeah. So, okay. We get a little cup. And I'm going to do two pours. So I have two cups. And do you know why? Because for the first time, I have two whites. And one of the whites is titanium white, which is opaque, like you know. And the other one is zinc white, and that is transparent. So I wanted to see what those two whites do to the other colors. So in this one, we're putting the... I don't even know which one it is. I forgot to put it on the cup. But I can feel this one is much heavier than this one. So I think this is the titanium. Then we're going to put in a bit of silver. And these are colors that someone requested. They said purple, ultramarine blue. But I added the quinoxidrone. I've lost it again, guys. But that pink color. So I thought I'd just add that just to make it a little bit more interesting. Then the blue. Pouring it in from up high because I think that is better for the cell forming. And anyone else that needs some help, please email me. And I'll send you the documentation I made. I made a little doc with some basic information. And now I'm feeling pretty stupid because this white reacts much better than that white. So I don't know which one it is. Well, I never said I was really smart, right? Little silver in there. I want to use all the paint. Some more silver in here. That's it. And in comes the pink from up high. And that's more than enough paint. So I'll have some left over. Okay, I gotta wipe this away. And then get my palette knife. That's that. Whoops. So my palette knives for the sides. I got my paint ready. I got my canvas ready, and it's time to do a little pour. So I thought I'd just, you know, I do so many flip cups. You've seen me do flip cups so much. So I thought I'd just do it by hand because I got my little push pins. See how easy this is? You just hold it by one of those push pins, and you can do anything with that canvas you like. You can hold it flat. You can hold it straight up. See how easy? That is, that was a really good tip. So here we go. A little bit of that one. Then some of this one. Then some of that one again. And that is more than enough. Then I'm gonna just hold it here. And tap it a little bit so that those bubbles come up. Because I see a lot of bubbles, but I also see other colors cells coming through the big cells, so that's pretty. Here they come. Ooh, there goes the paint. Now I'm looking for my torch, because I think I will torch it, and then see those bubbles. Well, not much of that pink came through, but who cares, you know, you get what you get. So I'm gonna put that over there a little bit, then put on some more, because I don't want to move the canvas too much. Some here, and pour that off there. Wow, I've got here pink cells inside. That is cute. Enough. That's enough. Just doing the sides a little bit. Whoop, don't let it fall. That's that side. And one last corner. That's it. Okay, let us look at this a bit. Well, it is different, and I almost never use these colors, so I'm gonna give it a little more torch, because I see a lot of air bubbles coming to the surface. About it. And the lighter, the lighter, it's, I bet you think it's white, but this is the silver, and this is the silver, and this is white paint. So this is gonna turn a different color when it dries, I'm pretty sure. Let's see if it has too much paint. Yes, it does. So I'm gonna just let some roll off a little bit, because otherwise you're gonna have trouble with it drying, and I'm afraid it just might crack. But I'm sure that the colors I used, they're not all Amsterdam acrylics. I used some different colors, and now this is a good experiment. Can you see how they break up here? Because the purple is a different brand. And you know something? I think I know what's the problem is that some people have. I don't think all acrylic paint is good for pouring. Look how this changed. You can go back a bit in this video, and you just go back and then go back again to this point, and you'll see the difference, how these cells are all deteriorating. And especially this bit. So I think that's the problem, because you know, anyone that follows me, you know, and watches all the videos, you know that I have been using like 75% of my videos are Amsterdam acrylics, and so I've never experienced this before. You can see up here, the cell formation is almost totally gone. Down here, where you just saw that I had this beautiful, big, beautiful cells, and then there was pink coming through. Now it's totally gone, and it wasn't due to the tilting, I'm pretty sure, because I didn't tilt that much. But they're just all falling apart. Here it's falling apart, there it's falling apart. So it is still a pretty canvas, but if you're going for those cells, I think the problem is the paint. You know, if you're really serious about this stuff, what I would do, wait a minute, what I would do is I'd buy, you don't have to go for those really big tubes of paint, but Amsterdam Acrylics has the tubes, they're 120 milliliters, and they should go for around, I pay €3.25 for a 120 milliliter, but you should buy like five colors. You pick out the beautiful colors. You go with the titanium white, 105. You have to have that one in there. And then you pick three transparent colors or half transparent, and then another opaque color. And I would do a pour with that. And I am expecting that a lot of people having trouble with making cells and keeping the cells will have much more cell formation, and it's gonna dry like you pour it, because usually my pores dry like I pour them. So I'll show you one. I guess you can remember this one. This one was from the video before this one. Look at all the cells. It's exactly the same, even this bit, and it's totally dry. It is exactly the same, and this is all Amsterdam acrylic. This is another one which I already varnished, but you can see that those cells all stayed there. The minute I put the canvas down, that's what I had and that's what stayed. So if you really want to do this, just, you know, I'm sure there are other brands out there that keep the cells also, but if you're having really trouble keeping the cells and everything runs together, then I'd really just buy five colors of Amsterdam acrylics and try it with that. And I'm pretty sure you're going to get really happy with that. So now I'm going to take you guys down, like I always do. Oh, this video is getting long. Some don't have a problem with that, but so some people do. So even though this is still a pretty painting, I still like it. But I would have loved it more if there was more cell formation like this. I would have liked that a lot more. So, oops, can't do that. I wanted to try to turn around the camera. But see, this is the top bit. That's the first pour. And then we have the second pour. And even though there's tons of cells and it's pretty, but it's still, look at those two different colors. Can you see that? And it really doesn't matter, because I'm going to be putting some sort of a, I don't know, metallic thing over the horizon thing that you see. So I'm going to be putting something over that. And I don't know, maybe it'll look interesting, because it's sort of like the top bit is mountains and the bottom bit is the reflection in the water. Something like that. That's what it looks like. Oh yeah, okay. So I'm gonna sign off before this becomes a video of 30 minutes. Gonna thank you all again, and I'm gonna see you all in the next video. And this weekend I'll be uploading 3 or 4 and doing another big pour. So see you all. In the meantime, make beautiful art and have fun. Bye bye.